Korea is celebrating the completion of its second research station in Antarctica. Why? Because this makes Korea part of an elite club. Our Kim Ji-yeon reports.
Korea is preparing for a new period of polar exploration with the completion of its second research station in Antarctica. A ceremony was held for the Jang Bo-go Station on Wednesday at Terra Nova Bay in northern Victoria Land. The new base will be able to accommodate up to 60 people with 16 buildings spread across a 4.5-square-kilometer plot of land. The new station will be a home base for geographic research, including the study of meteorites and glaciers. And the Korean government says the work done there can help promote scientific research at home.
지구상의 마지막 미 개척지인 남극은 기후 변화와 해양 생태계의 비밀을 간직한 자연 과학의 거대 실험장이자 수산 자원과 에너지 자원 등 막대한 자원을 보유한 기회의 대륙입니다.
Antarctica is known to be brewing with humankind's most important natural resources, including oil, metals, and copper. For that reason, the frozen continent is being looked at for exploration by many countries. For now, mining and territorial claims are prohibited on the continent under the Antarctic Treaty of 1959. But that will be up for review in the year 2048, which is why some countries may try to angle for a piece of the Antarctic pie before then. Korea's first station, the King's Hejong, was built in the western part of the continent in 1988, mainly conducting research on marine ecosystems. The United States was first to establish a station on the continent in 2008, and China has 4 stations in total, with a 5th planned for next year. Kim Ji-yeon, Arirang News.